Good morning, Mount Zion. Come on, wake up. Good morning. Will y'all please stand with me this morning? And I need your help on this song. I want you to sing it from your heart. It goes something like this.
Oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Singing, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Help me on this journey. Help me on my way. Singing, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Somebody say, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Oh, Lord, say, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Help me on my journey.
I say, Lord,
help me to pray. I say, help me to pray. While I'm on the sea, Jesus' journey.
In the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning, thanking you, praising you, giving you the honor and all the glory that you deserve for blessing us to be able to get up and come to the place where we can worship you freely. Thank you, Jesus. It has not always been that way, that we could worship freely. But now, Lord, through your goodness and your mercy, we can. So we thank you this morning for being a healer. We thank you this morning for being our doctor in the sick room. We thank you this morning for being the door that we need to walk through. We thank you this morning for the other door that you closed that we don't even need to go through. Father, we thank you for looking out for us and for looking out for our families and our friends. We thank you, Lord, for being just God and God alone. We ask, God, that as you be so good to us, you're such an amazing God, that we are such a disobedient children. Sometimes we sin and come short of your glory. We ask God this morning that you would please forgive us for sins of omission, sins of commission, sins of thinking bad thoughts about our sisters and our brothers, and deeds that we do that we know is not pleasing to you, but yet we do them anyway. But God, we ask this morning that you work with us, clean us up, and fit us for your glory so we can be the ambassadors and the representatives that you would have us to be. Because certainly when people look at us, they need to see you. So God, help us this morning. Father, I ask you for a special prayer for those children who came to this altar 2 weeks ago. I can't get them out of my head. 200 plus at this altar crying out. Father, we ask you to keep your hands on them. Bless them, keep them. We know that they are out there on the streets, and we pray, God, that you would keep them safe from all hurt, harm, and danger. We cannot just leave them without keeping them in our prayers. So, God, for the mothers and the fathers, the sisters and the brothers who they represent in their households, we ask for prayer for all of them. And now, Lord, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you for being so good to us in spite of us, because we are sometimes hard to be good to. But God, you keep on being good. You don't stop. And you don't foreclose on us, and you don't turn your back on us, but you keep on being good to us, and you keep on lifting us up, and you keep on giving us our daily bread, and you keep on feeding us, and you keep on clothing us, and you keep on giving us a place to stay where we don't have to stay outside. Thank you, God. Father, we ask this morning, as the man of God come before you, that you would give him the anointing that he always brings to the pulpit, and bless him indeed as he feed us the word of God. We thank you, thank you, thank you. And lastly, we thank you for sending your son Jesus to the cross to die for us that we may have a better life. We can never repay you for that. The best we can do is live our best life. So we ask you, God, give us the strength to do it. In your son Jesus' name, amen.
Let us stand for our mission and vision and the fire court badges. This is my right hand, my bodyguard, and my one and only, Sister McCullough. And our mission, to impact the world by the good of believers, to reach the lost through the gospel of Jesus Christ. And our vision, to bring about an effective change with the two men leaders of the church and beyond.
And our five core values: we love unconditionally, we give generously, we serve enthusiastically, we grow intentionally, we witness consistently. Have a great day, Mount Zion.
Been walking with my face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can when I can, while I can, for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with. Start moving. separating line. I'm wading through muddy waters. You know I got a made up mind, and I don't mind if I lose any blood on the way to salvation. And I fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. And I know
continue the life and legacy of the late Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. May it be very clear that the Dr. King observance is not a one-day event. We will continue throughout our lifetime and span here at the Mount Zion Church of carrying out that life and legacy of nonviolence, peace, education, and equality. This is not my platform to make my statement concerning what's going on in our very own state, but be ye clear that we will continue to teach our rich legacy and history. There would be no institution or organization that would dictate to us what we will teach, when we will teach it, and how we will teach it. For it had not been for our culture and our African American inventors, doctors, and lawyers, there would be no education. all night, all day. The angels keeps watching over me. Bless your name, Lord. The song says the angels, it keep watching. Watching over me both day and night. All down through the years. Here we go.
Only see the worst in me. I tell you one more time, one more time? I said he saw the best in me.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one. Hey,
he saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me,
could only see the worst in me.
Does anybody have that testimony? When folk walked you off, said you would never make it, what did he see?
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me, can I tell y'all one more thing? I just need to tell you one more thing. Listen to this. See, he's mine, and I am his. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. Does anybody know that tonight? Oh, see, he is mine, and I am his. Said it doesn't matter what I did. See, he only sees me for who I am.
Help me sing it.
The girl said that he is mine.
He's mine.
I'm his.
I'm his.
Said it doesn't matter what
doesn't
I did.
Matter what I did.
He only sees me for who I am.
He only sees me
yeah.
for who I
yeah.
am.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Tonight. Can I ask y'all one question? The question is simply this. What did he see?
He saw the best.
I can't get no help up in here. Because there are some folk in here that people have wrote you off. Said you would never amount to anything. Said that you would never end up being anywhere. But Myron, tell him one more time. What did he see?
He saw the best.
When mama said you would never be nothing, when aunties and uncles said that you'd never amount to anything, when daddy didn't come home anymore, he didn't look at you and say that you weren't going to make it. God looked at you, and what did he see? What did he see?
He saw the best. The best.
What did he see?
The best.
I said, 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 what did he see?
Seeing the best in all of us. Your mercies are renewed every morning. Great is thou faithfulness. Forgive me for all of my sins omission and commission. Use me, God, to finish my journey. Call me. Hold me, Lord. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Truly, it is good to be in the house of the Lord. So thankful that we have the church that we can go to. Hopefully, at the church, we can find help, healing, forgiveness, compassion. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Please turn in your Bibles to the book of Nehemiah. Nehemiah chapter 2. I want to read verses 17 through 20. Thank you so very much for your prayers. Thank you for the words of encouragement. The pastor shouldn't be the only one praying. The book of Nehemiah, chapter 2, verses 17 through 20. Hear the word of the Lord. Then said I unto them, you see the distress that we are in, how Jerusalem lieth waste, and the gates thereof are burned with fire. Come, and let us build up the wall of Jerusalem, that we be no more a reproach. Then I told them of the hand of my God, which was good upon me, as also the king's words that he had spoken unto me. They said, let us rise up and build. So they strengthened their hands for this good work. But when Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the servant, the Ammonite, and Geshem the Arabian heard it, they laughed us to scorn and despised us and said, what is this thing that you do? Will you rebel against the king? Then answered I them and said unto them, the God of heaven, he will prosper us. Therefore, we his servants will arise and build. But you have no portion nor right nor memorial in Jerusalem. Thank you. You may be seated in the presence of the Most High God. And they said, let us rise up and build. So they strengthened their hands for this good work. I want to continue this series, Reset, Reclaim, Rebuild. I want to title this text, The Will to Build. The will to build. I'm so glad that Dr. Parrott sung the song that the choir had sung. the words that he said, because this really is exactly where I'm at, that now that, thank you, ushers, you may be seated, now that the parade is over, the bands have gone home, we've had our breakfasts, speeches, and given awards. Now what? Now what? It really is a year on and never a day off. We have so much work to do. And we need to stay focused. No matter what the enemy throws at us, we have to stay focused. Amen. It is my prayer that I finish strong. I wish I can stand here and tell you that there is no flaws in me. I am man, a human being. But just like you see in the text, people will always take the opportunity to discourage and kick us, especially when we are down. And I'm not mad at no one. I'm not even mad at myself. And the reason why I can look you in the face and tell you why I'm not mad at myself, because God is answering my prayers. This series is not something cute to say. This series come from heaven for us for such a time as this, that we need to reset, reclaim, rebuild. And I don't mind him doing that, first of all, in me, to reset me. I wasn't going to share this with you, but I'm going to share with you the first part of my ministry. I walked such a straight and narrow, nothing. And you have to be careful, because one of the last sins that you have to overcome is self-righteousness. And I had the audacity to say to God, how can you take my wife when I've served you so faithfully? And I struggled with that. And my deepest intimate prayers, the first part of pastoring was hours and hours of prayer, prostrated on my face for you, for this church, for this community. And that was interrupted the last time Mina got sick. God called her home. I couldn't talk to him. Couldn't talk to him like that because I was angry. I couldn't stand to see her the way she was. So after ministering all day, I would go home. Honey, is there anything I can do for you? No, babe. Quit asking me. You're making me feel worse. And I would go sit in my recliner and drink myself to sleep. We are creatures of habit. Nobody can tell us how long to grieve. I make no excuses. I just say that those of you who know me, who know my heart, just pray for me. You're going to have critics. When you were doing God's work. And so my first point in this text, because it's right there, is accept the critics. Accept those who are going to hinder you. Amen. Even if you're doing good, they're going to talk about you. So it really doesn't matter. People are going to say what they want to say. They're going to do what they want to do. You could do all this good, and one slip up, you're the worst person in the world. And see, that's why people really need to get to know Jesus. Because Jesus forgives us of our sins. But here it is, Nehemiah had a heart for his people and had received favor from the king and favor from God. And when he went home, back home, to rebuild the city of Jerusalem, there were some Sanballats and Tobias that ridiculed him. It's in the text. Verse 10 says, when Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the servant and the Ammonite heard of it, heard of this good work, it grieved them exceedingly that there was come a man to seek the welfare of the children of it. I dare somebody to try to make life better. And Nehemiah, we are in good company. King, Dr. Martin Luther King, young man, didn't even get to be 40 years old. It was church people, community people. There were folk that everybody didn't love Dr. King. Many people thought that what he was doing was wrong. Stop messing with the status quo. But Dr. King was determined to make life better for you and for me. Now we've gotten complacent. Now we have become lethargic and self-satisfied and unconcerned with the condition of our people. And I'm here to tell you that we really are in trouble. Our walls are torn down. You and I are okay because we live in our nice little communities. We got enough money for the month. We have a nice home and we got a good family, husband and wife, and doing all right. But there are some folk who are struggling just to make it. Children looking to the streets for leadership and guidance. The disrespect and the self-hatred that we impose upon one another is real. It's not about bricks and mortar. It's about programs and services, wraparound services to come alongside folk and help them. That's where my heart is. I could care less about how my name get drugged through the mud. Don't matter. It's been drugged through the mud. But I'm going to be like Nehemiah. I'm going to keep on keeping on. He says, so I came to Jerusalem and was there 3 days. 3 days He had to rest from that long travel, that long journey. He rested and got it. And I'm sure that he prayed while he was resting and rested and while he prayed, he was getting his strength back to go and assess the condition that Jerusalem was in. See, we're going to have critics, accept the critics, but now you got to assess the condition. There needs to be some concern about Pookie and Ray Ray and Chiquita. There needs to be some concern about what's going on. I rose in the night, I and some few men with me, and nobody goes at it alone. I thank God for the men and the women of Mount Zion that continue to hold my arms up. I know who you are. I may not say, but I know who you are. Day in and day out, interceding. Need help, call you there. He had a few men with him. Neither told any of them, my God, put in my heart to do at Jerusalem. Neither was there any beast with me, save the one that I rode on. But he went and he surveyed the land and saw that the walls of Jerusalem broken down, the gates consumed with fire. The condition was bad. And right now, we have a fight on our hand. We have a governor that's doing everything in his power to turn back the hands of time. We need to be concerned about what DeSantis is doing, because he's got a Harvard education. He knows, amen, the real situation of woke. Amen. He knows that it is systemic injustices and racism that is in the fabric of this nation. He knows. Amen. He knows what we have dealt with, what we have come through. You can't go to Harvard and Yale and not get that kind of information. But like the maestro said, we built our own schools. Amen. We weren't supposed to be mayors and governors and presidents and doctors and lawyers and businessmen and businesswomen. We weren't supposed to be that. We were supposed to be slaves. But the devil is a liar. Amen. Yeah, we gotta come together and advocate for the cause. Yeah, we gotta come together and say, look here, something has got to be done. Amen. And it's good that we could come to church and shout and sing and all of that, but there's a public outcry that should take place. There needs to be a support. We need to promote the movement. Amen. Because we are in a moment of movement. There's changes coming. You don't even know it, but behind the scenes, I've been on the forefront for a long time. Amen. You don't even know it, but God had me on duty for a minute. Even when I was working for the Boy Scouts of America, not even realizing that Boy Scouts of America came from the Zulu tribe of South Africa. And then it was kept away from us in our community. One little pack, one troop, but in 4 years, God allowed it to grow to 500 boys at one time. Eagle Scouts, Jerry Carter, Eagle Scouts, Lewis Murphy, Eagle Scouts, Michael Shorter, but on and on and on. Rebuild it, because I realize that until we pour into our children, till we have programs that can gird them up, and we got to have institutions now to teach our children. And the first thing we need to teach them is respect. T-
To teach the children, we got to teach the parents that haven't been taught and the grandparents that have not been taught. We got to wrap around services. We got to go into the whole family. On the lines, working with Vero Davis and Watson Haynes and all them for COQUEAR, Concerned Organization for the Quality Education of Black Students, CRA. We developed that. We brought CR, Community Redevelopment Area, millions of dollars to come into this community on the south side. And many of you ought to be applying for those grants. They didn't want us to do the CBA. What is CBA? Community Benefit Agreement. All those high rises going downtown, dollars should be going back into the fund to do some stuff on this side of town. $92 million for a pier. Many of you don't even go to, but yet and still, all that development along Central Avenue, First Avenue, Beach Drive, but come down to Deuces, 22nd Street and 16th Street, and what do you see? The walls are torn down. Lorraine's Hotel, that was the place where the Negro baseball players slept at because they couldn't sleep downtown. And you don't want us to speak truth. You gotta know your history or you're doomed to repeat it. I don't want a pastor no other church but an African-American church. And I'm not prejudiced, I just love my people. So many organizations, the founder of Agenda 2010, from 2010 to 2020 plan, one community, now the Equity Institute trying to again bring about economic development and enhancement for people in our community, young folks that's trying to make it. That's what it's about. That's the work. Amen. And in the process, we're going to build buildings. We're building Sankofa. Amen. And even though we're going through a lot of drills and stuff and push-ups down at the city, we're going to get it done. Through tax credits and whatever grants we can get it, we're going to get it. We don't have the millions and millions of dollars that they have obtained off the backs of our people. Taking our resources to enrich themselves. That's truth. Generational wealth. And sold us. $100 and $200 life policies. When a funeral today, the average funeral today costs $6,000-$7,000. This is the rebuilding that has to take place. That is why I'm okay. I'm okay with whatever God has in store because I'm sold out to Him. I'm going to finish my course, and I'm going to finish strong. We got to advocate the cause. We got to come together and speak those things that are not as though they were. It's not good enough just to have a black in office, and there's no slight to our mayor or any other black elected official. What I'm saying to you, in the fabric of this nation, in the laws and the policies, is works against us. And anybody that don't think that racism is real, there's something really wrong with them. And there are some black people that don't think there's no racism. I got my job and I went to school. Really? Really? I'm born in the South. I've been here for 64 years. I've lived it. I've seen it. In corporate America, I've seen it in the Marines. Marine Corps was the last branch of the armed forces to integrate. They wanted that completely white. We'll let you come in the Army, Navy, but last one. And I felt it. I dealt with it. But it couldn't stop me. Amen. And many others dealt with it and would not let it stop them. Frank Peterman, the highest ranking Marine officer when I was in over the whole Pacific Basin, was a pilot. That's what I wanted to be. I wanted to fly jets. Why? Because I just felt I could fly jets. Didn't even know it that my fifth grade teacher, Charles P. Bailey, was a Tuskegee Airman that flew jets. We didn't even have a clue who was in our classroom. That's why we got to teach our children our history. He says in verse 17, "Then I said unto them, you see the distress that we are in." I like that. We. Because Nehemiah said, y'all, them. And we have a tendency to follow that narrative, thinking that we're not included. Amen. Because we can sit at certain tables. Help me, Lord Jesus. But thanks be to God, we got some folk, amen, who understand that we are in this all together. How Jerusalem lieth, where how St. Petersburg and many cities across this nation lie waste. Homes are broken. Children are being exported, imported, whatever, straight out of school into correctional institutions. Our correctional institutions are overcrowded with us. The laws are even stacked against us, that folk can get off on stuff that we can't get off on. Do not fool yourself one moment. If there was been some black folk at the Capitol talking about busting down doors and busting windows, that would have been a bloodbath. People say, Pastor, don't politic. No, the Bible is political. You're talking about setting up kingdoms, tearing down kingdoms, kings, governors. It's all political. Don't get so holy that you miss the word of God. Let us build. Let us, Mount Zion, let us come together and build. And that's what you've been doing, whether you know it or not. Under this administration, you've been building, setting the groundwork. It's taken us 20-some years, but we've been doing something. I promise you, we've been doing something. You may not think so, but we have been. Right now, God is not making any more land, but we bought up 2 blocks of land. We crying over $2 million. We probably, I don't even know what our net worth is right now, but it's well over $2 million. That's what God has been doing. And we're setting things up for those that are coming behind us. I had a good conversation with Puff yesterday. Puff said, Pastor, you don't even know I grew up in Mount Zion. Buried his mother here when they were little boys. Pastor, I need the God is telling me to come back. We need to go back and get our young people that have come through Mount Zion and continue the work that God has called us to. They get cute sometimes because so many times they don't understand our faults, our fractures, our failures. They look at us and they look at the word and they say, wait a minute, they don't line up. But they'll get to the place where they understand. All sin and come short of the glory of God. We all need him. Nobody is perfect. His grace and his mercy is extended to us every day. Thank you, Jesus, for your grace and your mercy. How you continue to bless us in spite of us. Thank you. And don't make people think that you're so holy that you can't they can't even reach you. One of the greatest victories came out of this embarrassment was a lady calling me in tears, wailing. Pastor, I can't get up in the morning time without having a drink. Help me. That meant everything to me. I'll take the embarrassment. I know what to do. I'm no fool. I know how to do, follow the laws and so forth. I just happened to break that one. But in the meantime, it wasn't that serious, but didn't steal. I won't say nothing about it because some of y'all said, well, he's trying to justify it. Don't worry about it. I know what I'm talking about. It was because I hit that reset button. I hit the reset button, and it starts with me. Lord, I want to start over again. I want to go back to where I first fell in love with you. That's what I want to do. People don't understand spiritual warfare. 2023 will be a great year. It's going to be a great year because we're going to reset, reclaim, rebuild, continue the work that God has called us to. I don't know about you, but I'm excited. I feel exuberated. I feel like I can run on. I feel like I got my strength back. I know where my help comes. All my help coming from the Lord. All of it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let us build so that we be no more reproach. When you understand your worth and allow God to build your wealth, you will be a force to reckon with. He's looking for vessels that he can use. Do you see the crazies that are coming out of the cracks and the corners that's trying to lead our government? Where is morals, values, decency? The love for humanity, where is that at, Marjorie Taylor Greene and the rest of y'all crooks and cronies? You were so disappointed. You felt like the country had gone to hell because you had black people in the White House. Okay, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. We just leave that alone. Amen. But I'm telling you, we went from one extreme, and we're going to take our country back, and we're going to use orangutan, an orange orangutan, to do it. Then I told them of the hand of my God, which was good. You note takers, accept the critics, assess the condition, advocate the cause, but acknowledge the Creator. Acknowledge the Creator. I'm done, Mount Zion. He will prosper us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Yeah, you got to know that God. Right there in verse 20, he will prosper us. The God of heaven, he will make us successful. Yeah, he's going to help us to succeed. Yeah. See, but prosperity is more than money and the accumulation of wealth, but rather an ongoing state of success that touches every area of our lives. You got to know that my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Amen. We have come this far by faith, and we will not turn around. Amen. God, the Creator, he gave favor to Nehemiah with the king. And then the king gave Nehemiah a visa to travel. Not only to give him a visa to travel, but he gave him a voucher for materials to rebuild the wall. Not only to give him a visa and a voucher, but he gave him an army to protect him so that he can get from point A to point B. Do y'all see my God in this story? Our God, God will, our God, the God of heaven, he will prosper us. See, God said, I know the thoughts that I think toward you. He said, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. God said, yes, this will come to pass. The vision of Mount Zion will come to pass. Therefore, we, his servants, we will rise and build. I like that. I thank God about that. Amen. Because somebody told me the other day, and I thought it was a wise thing. They say, look here, I don't want to fall in love. I want to rise in love. I'm just telling you, Mount Zion, I want to rise to the height of love for my divine God, for my Savior, the God of heaven. You can trust him, our heavenly creator. Anybody know him as the author and the finisher of our faith? Abraham trusted him to leave his country unto a land that God was going to show him. And then later on, in 10 chapters later, Abraham again trusted God. Now take your son, your only son, Isaac, the one who you love, who's the apple of your eye, and get up to a land up in Mount Moriah, or to a mountain that I'm going to show you. And right there, I want you to sacrifice your son Isaac. But I thank God that Isaac wasn't sacrificed, because Isaac wasn't sacrificed. Then he came along and trusted God by blessing Jacob with the Abrahamic covenant. Moses trusted God on the backside of the Egyptian desert. He said, go tell Pharaoh to let my people go. I'm so glad that we got a great cloud of witnesses that learned how to trust God. David trusted God, amen, to defeat a 9-foot giant. I'm so glad that we got a great cloud of witnesses that know how to trust God. Elijah trusted God up against Baal, who was a worshiper of evil. Elijah trusted God during the famine and was fed by a raven, bread and meat, and drunk water from a brook. Daniel, he trusted God in the lion's den. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they trusted God in the fiery furnace. Do I have a witness up in here? Rahab, the harlot, she trusted God and her family by putting a scarlet cord in the window. Come on here, Mary. Mary trusted God with an immaculate conception and gave birth to our Savior, the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Peter trusted God and he walked on water. Blind Bartimaeus by the wayside trusted God. Lord, have mercy on me. Do I have a witness up in him? Jesus trusted God in the garden of Gethsemane. He said, Lord, if it be another way, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine will be done. Good morning, Mount Zion. You can trust your heavenly Father. You can trust the divine creator that spoke everything into existence. Can't nothing happen without God saying so. Ain't he all right? Ain't God all right? He'll make a way out of no way. Anybody in here, does anybody believe that our God, he will fight your battles. He will make a way out of no way. Good morning, Mount Zion. Don't worry about me. I'm pressing on. I have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Bye. beloved, we've come to the part of the service where eternal life is at stake. This is where we offer salvation to you if you do not have it. If you haven't said yes to God, if you haven't joined with Jesus or connected with Christ, God says that he loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten son, that if you believe in him, you shall not perish, but you shall have everlasting life. As I stand here today, I want to offer you salvation. Oh, my brother and my sister, if you don't want to walk with yourself, we have people that will walk with you and will talk with you. Would you please stand to your feet at this time? Give your life to Christ. Do you feel like going on to eternity? If your last breath was your last breath, would your salvation be secure? If not, please stand at this time. Those of you on the internet, would you please type in your salvation request to our internet community? We have people that will respond. This is your time. This is your moment. Secondly, if you have decided to join Mount Zion and make Mount Zion your church home, would you please stand at this time so that we can offer you membership and fellowship? We would love to have you. Finally, we are a house of prayer. We do really believe that the prayers of the righteous avail much. If you stand in the need of prayer, would you rise to your feet? Amen. Amen. Would you step out and retire to our prayer room? We have prayer warriors there that are willing to pray with you and pray for you. Amen. Listen. The request bears repetition. If you're not saved, if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, don't go another second, another minute, or another hour.
Yeah.
I beg of you, sir, ma'am, please give your life to Christ. I promise you he'll make your life brand new. And yes, he will take care of you. If for some reason you cannot stand to respond to our request, to my right, your left, we have a new membership room. One of our deacons is in the back, ready to receive you and offer you salvation. Not him, but he'll take you through the steps of salvation. Amen. He'll offer you church membership and direct you to our prayer room. By everyone sitting, I pray that God has given you life everlasting. I pray that you have a church home where you're going and growing. And finally, I hope God has answered all your prayers according to his riches and glory. Amen. Amen. Thank you for your obedience. Let's bless our pastor at this time for that powerful message. Continue to be in prayer for him as he goes through this troublesome hour. Pastor, my heart is with your heart. I want to say to you, congregation, pray for our pastor. You need to understand the difference between Peter and Judas. They were both God's elect. Peter denied Christ. Peter had a bad day. Judas set up Jesus. He had a bad heart. Our pastor has a great heart. So again, let's continue to reset, reclaim, and rebuild. Amen? Amen. Do we have any visitors here today? If you're a guest and you are a visitor, would you please stand at this time so that we could recognize you? Any guests that are here, would you please stand and remain standing? Amen. So that we could recognize you at this time. Amen. To you, my sister, and those listening on the internet, on behalf of Pastor Murphy, we want to welcome you to our church. We hope you had a chance to relax and make yourself at home. We hope you had a chance to reflect on just how good God has been to you. I know you received the word, and I pray that you received it so that you can leave here refreshed and revived and ready for the world. We have an open door policy here. That means anytime our doors are open, you can return and we'll welcome you all over again. We love you. God bless you. God keep you. As you take your seat, Mount Zion, let's give our guests a hand. It's time to give. There's a story in the Bible, and I believe it was Jesus. He challenged this young man to sell his possessions and give to the needy. He said, "Provide yourself with money bag do not grow old, with a treasure in the heavens that does not fail, where no thief approaches and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there will be your heart also." Mount Zion, where is your heart when you come to church? Is it in your family? Is it in your wealth? Is it in your limitations? I want to invite you today to sow an eternal legacy by giving to God from the treasures that you cannot take with you. Amen? So while you're prayerfully considering what you will give to God today, while you're building your legacy through giving, please focus your attention on the screens for our morning announcements.
This week at Mount Zion. Worship with us every Sunday with Pastor Lewis M. Murphy Sr. at 7:45 and 10 a.m. The Vision 300 Capital Campaign for 2022 is still open. Make your donation or pledge today. Use this card to invite others to be a part of the Vision 300 Capital Campaign. Join the Mount Zion Lunch Pals and become a mentor to students within our neighborhood schools. The interest meeting will be January 22nd after the 10 a.m. service in the Youth Chapel. For more information, please email 180@mzprogressive.org. The Kumbania Center for the Performing Arts and Cultural Studies at Mount Zion open house and informational session will be Sunday, January 29th at 4 p.m. Classes for 3rd through 12th grade include drumline, dance, mime, piano, violin, voice, drama and acting, fashion and design, character development, creative writing, and public speaking. For more information, please contact Dr. Kevin B. Parrott at 727-894-4311, extension 224. Come join the Women of Zeal Ministries kickball game Sunday, January 22nd at 4 p.m. at Lake Vista Park. All members are invited to the church business meeting Saturday, February 4th at 7:45 a.m. via Zoom. Join the Mount Zion Panhellenic Council for Black History Sundays in the month of February during the 10 a.m. service. Represent your Greek organization. Reception for guest Greek organizations to follow after the 10 a.m. service. Join the Couples Ministry, Building a Better Marriage with You, Parts 1 and 2, Sunday, January 22nd at 6 p.m. via Zoom. For more information, contact Minister Choi and Linda Gidron at 727-864-3550. Donate blood here at Mount Zion, Sunday, January 22nd from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. Join us for a chronological reading of the Bible for 2023. Select your plan and start your reading. Selections are available online at mzprogressive.org. Here to help you. Mount Zion Food Distribution is every second and fourth Friday from noon to 1:30 in the main church parking lot. Children's Church is now open for grades K through 5 every second, third, and fourth Sunday at 10 a.m. You can submit announcements in two easy ways. Complete the announcement request form on mzprogressive.org or send an email to vellis@mzprogressive.org. For more information, please call the church office at 727-894-4311. Download our app, submit prayer requests, make donations and pay tithes, use online Bible, receive alerts and messages, and more. Our youth prayer line is weekly, Monday through Friday, from 6 to 6:30 a.m. via Zoom. Join us for a mindful movement, Wednesdays from 5 to 6 in the gym. The magic is real. Meetings are open to anyone wanting to get clean and stay sober from drug addiction. Tuesdays at 7 p.m. here at Mount Zion on the second floor. For more information, please email recovery@mzhs.org. Need a ride to church? Please contact the church office by Friday at 12 p.m. at 727-894-4311. Need to report an illness, hospitalization, or death of a member or relative?
please call the church office at 727-894-4311 or text 727-873-9177 or email vellis@mzprogressive.org. Looking for ways to give? Text MZ Progressive to 73256 directly from your phone. Go online to mzprogressive.org and click Give. Contact your bank to set up Mount Zion as a payee. Mail a check or money order directly to the church, or drop off your donation in the drop box located on the east side of the main church.
The weekday prayer line is open Monday through Friday. Live prayer begins at 6 a.m. To join, please call 667-770-1536. Use access code 910-772-POUND.
This concludes our announcements. Have a blessed week, Mount Zion.
Let's greetings to each of you. I am Dr. Kevin Parrott, the proud and excited and blessed minister of worship, music, and arts at the Mount Zion Progressive Missionary Baptist Church, where we are engaging and educating and empowering the communities throughout Pinellas County, and especially right here in Midtown St. Pete, where we exist to extend the love, the life, and the lordship of Jesus Christ to everyone in every way, in every place, and at every time the opportunity is given. I am so excited about the opportunity God has given us here at Mount Zion to reset, reclaim, and rebuild. We are not going to miss this graced opportunity to change and grow. With all that has been said, on behalf of Impact Ministry, Music, Performing Arts, and Choirs, it gives me great pleasure and honor to introduce and present the Kumbania Center for Performing Arts and Cultural Studies here at Mount Zion. However, first, let us learn the power behind the name. Kumba and Nia are two of the seven principles of Kwanzaa. Kumba means creativity, to always do as much as we can in the way we can to leave our community more beautiful and beneficial than we inherited. And Nia means purpose, to make our collective vocation the building and the developing of our community to restore our people to their traditional greatness. Now that is powerful. We are using the arts to reach our children, youth, and teens, in addition to teaching civility and understanding their need for God, a Savior. Here at the Kumbania Center, we will offer classes for students in the 3rd to 12th grades. We will later add classes for adults. The classes are as follows: drumline, dance, mime, piano, violin, voice, drama, fashion and design, creative writing, public speaking, and character development. To learn more about the Kumbania Center, join me in an open house and informational session on Sunday, January the 29th at 4 o'clock p.m. right here at Mount Zion in the main sanctuary. You do not want to miss this monumental time of resetting, reclaiming, and rebuilding our children, youth, and teens to restore them to their God-given greatness. Mount Zion, this is our time. Let us not miss these doors and windows of opportunities to impact our city, communities, and culture. Our children, youth, and teens are no longer the generation of tomorrow and the future. They are our today and now. Thank you, and may the Lord bless you real good.
Amen. Thank you, media, for those timely announcements. Would you please raise your offerings at this time so that we could bless them? Father, we thank you for the opportunity to worship you through giving. I ask that you bless those who gave, God. I ask that you have mercy on those who could give and did not. And for those who could not give, God, I pray increase in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen. Would you please drop your envelopes in the receptacles as you exit the sanctuary. A few more announcements before we turn the pulpit over to Pastor. Due to the leadership workshop this week, the office will be closed at 12 p.m. on Thursday and will be closed all day on Friday. Again, I want to repeat We will have our next business meeting for the church on Saturday, February 4th at 7:45 a.m. via Zoom. The media credentials will be sent out next week. All members are invited to attend. Today, from the hours of 8 to 1, at the Human Services Building, Mount Zion is having a blood drive. So if you desire to participate, they will gladly receive your blood. With all Greeks, meet with Dr. Parrott in the overflow to my left, your right, at the conclusion of this service. And at this time, I would like to call Reverend Carlia Jordan and Dean Frank Miller up in front of the congregation for an update on the Capitol campaign and the Vision 300. Due to time, we're going to not do that. Pastor, would you come up for the benediction? We have Sunday school going on right now.
Thank you, Minister Sim. Let us stand. I do want to encourage you to stay for Sunday school. We have great Sunday school teachers. Amen. Father, in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus, Lord, thank you for your word today. Thank you for just a super anointing of your power and your Holy Spirit. Bless each and everyone under the sound of my voice. Hold them, keep them, just shield them. We ask now that you would dismiss us from this place, but never, ever, ever from your presence. And it is in the mighty name of Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray and ask it all. Let all hearts say amen, amen, amen. God bless you. Wave at somebody, tell them you love them.